Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well. I'm going to do something a little bit different instead of my regular nail art where I explain what I'm doing. Boring. I'm going to talk about myth, legends, urban legends, ghosts and mysteries while doing my nails. And all the products I use in this video, I'm going to put it in the description box. So okay, let's get started. Since it is a Christmas season, I'm going to talk about the opposite of Saint Nick. He is called Krampus. So Krampus is a very popular legend in Europe. He is a half-goat, half-demon that punishes misbehaving children during the Christmas season. I know, that's horrible. Anyways, the history of Krampus' figure has been theorized as stretching back to pre-Christian Alpine traditions. He also is the devilish companion of Saint Nicholas. Krampus is believed to have originated in Germany or Austria, depending on which source you get the info, because all my sources is like here and there, so I apologize again if I get it wrong. So his name derives from the German word Krampen, which means claw. I hope I don't butcher that word. Is it right? Krampen? Krampen? Ooh, I'm sorry again, I apologize. I'm bad at this. Okay, although Krampus appears in many variations, most share some common physical characteristic. He is hairy, usually brown or black, and has cloven hooves and horns of a goat. His long pointed tongue lolls out, and he has fangs. Krampus also carries chains, thought to symbolize the binding of the devil by the Christian church. He thrashes the chain for dramatic effect. The chains are sometimes accompanied with bells of various sizes. Krampus is also known to carry a sack or a basket strapped to his back. Some of the older versions make mention of naughty children being put in a bag and taken away later to be eaten or drag them back to hell. This is getting better and better, isn't it, for the kids? Okay, so basically Krampus is a made-up story for parents to scare their children if they misbehave. And if I were a kid, I would be terrified with all the stories, right? It just doesn't get any better than this for the kids. Krampus also thought to have been part of the pagan ritual for the winter solstice. According to legend, he is the son of Hel, the Norse god of the underworld. With the spread of Christianity, Krampus became associated with Christmas. I don't know how that happened, but it happens. And despite effort for the Catholic Church to ban him, and they were unsuccessful. So Krampus comes from the olden days where people worship pagan gods. Now we know. So when did Krampus terrorize this kid? Well, the creature and Saint Nicholas are said to arrive on the evening of December 5th. While Saint Nicholas rewards nice children by leaving presents, Krampus beats the hell out of those kids who are naughty with branches and sticks. Actually, it sounds like my mom or my dad, you know, when I was a kid. I mean, I'm Asian. Our parents beat us up with sticks and whatever they can get their hands on. Okay, back to the story. Now, again, in some cases, he is said to eat them or take them to hell. I don't really know how he chose a kid for him to eat. I guess it depends on how bad the kids were, maybe. So on December 6th, St. Nicholas Day, children awaken to find either their gifts or nurse their injuries. Well, that's horrifying for the kids. Is Krampus being celebrated in some ways? Well, festivities involving Krampus includes the Krampuslauf. I hope I pronounced that right. I will put it on the screen for you guys to see. It means Krampus run. In this activity, people dress as the creature, parade through the streets, scaring spectators and sometimes chasing them. I don't know whether they chase kids or adults, but that's what it said. Beginning in the late 20th century, amid efforts to preserve cultural heritage, Krampus Run became increasingly popular in Austria and Germany. During this, Krampus began to celebrate internationally. I wouldn't want to celebrate that, because I don't like people chasing me around dressed as Krampus, no. Definitely not. No way. Hell no. Because it is very popular in pop culture, instead of fearing him, they idolize this creature to make movies, cards, and other stuff. Like the celebration that I mentioned earlier, where they dress as Krampus and chase people around. Now, I've seen a lot of Krampus movies being made, but I haven't actually watched any of them. I probably will after this, depending on the rating. You know, let's get sidetracked a bit. Sometimes I wish he really exists, because, you know, sometimes kids are the devil, I can tell you that. I mean, I have a 3-year-old, and he can be obnoxious. Don't get me wrong, I mean, I love my kid, but you know that feeling where you just wish something will scare them until they behave like a little angel. So anyways, that's all I got about this creature. I tried to do more research about him, but I couldn't find anything at all. I mean, not much story about him. There's also no actual sightings on Krampus anywhere. I believe it's just a myth. Or not. Because it depends, right? If I ever see one, then I know it's real. So what do you guys think? Do you believe in Krampus? Or he's just like Santa Claus that we believe as kids, but not as an adult? Okay, I hope I did a good job on this first episode of me talking about myth and legends. I haven't found the right name for it yet. So let me know if you like me doing my nails this way, because I really enjoy talking about these things with you guys. Also, leave a comment down below and let me know your thoughts on this video. And don't forget to let me know as well, what do you think of these nails? Again, I apologize if my facts are wrong. Maybe any of you knows more about this, can explain in detail about Krampus. And you can comment down below as well. Alright, have a very Merry Christmas from me to you. And please behave, or Krampus might come and get you instead of Santa. It's time for me to go. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you next time. Pleasant dreams.